Hi, this is Linda from Let's Talk Prepping. In my first video, I told you I would keep you up to date on my prepping journey. I want to show you my newest prep and what I'm doing with it. And in the meantime, if you have anything you'd like us to know, please put it in the comments and subscribe. Thank you. My newest prep item is a raised bed for my gardening. The way things are going now, we won't be able to store enough food for the years to come. And we're going to have to supplement with our own gardens. Now, my food supplies are not really up to snuff, and I will definitely need to grow my own food. I did try this year growing food, didn't have very good luck with it. First of all, I am down a hill, and I don't get a lot of sunlight. I would need to cut down some trees, but they're on my neighbor's property, so I can't. Secondly, I have voles or some kind of underground critters and tunnels all over my lawn, and they have eaten the plants from underneath. Third, I have deer, and they eat the plants from the top. So the voles or something eat under, and the deers eat from above, and there's not much left after that. For instance, a week or so ago, I checked my two squash plants, and I had a small yellow squash. I decided to let it grow a bit more, and I check it right before the first frost. And when I went out to check it, it was gone. You know, sometimes you see a tomato with a bite out of it, but this was totally gone. Was it a raccoon, a skunk? I don't know, but something ate it or took it. I decided to buy a raised bed, and they were out of stock for quite a while. So if you want to get one, you better try it now. So I bought two Vego, V-E-G-O, Veggio Garden Raised Beds. I guess it's Veggio Garden Raised Beds. I bought the 9-in-1 with a 32-inch height, so I don't have to bend over as much. You know, as you get older, it gets harder to stand up if you're sitting or kneeling on the ground. I will also have to fence it in, and then I hope that the height of the bed will deter the voles from getting up high enough to get the plant. I've just started to put it together, and when it's done, I'll let you see the finished product. I'm going to try to use the Hugel culture technique to fill it. Hugel, H-U-G-E-L-K-U-L-T-U-R, Hugel culture technique to fill it. They say you can fill it a little over halfway up with cardboard, logs, twigs, leaves, hay, and then put dirt on top and then compost. So what you're going to do is you put some cardboard on the bottom, so put really big logs down, then you put the twigs all around in between all the logs and the leaves and the hay, and then you put the dirt on and then you put the compost. So we'll see how that works out. I plan on getting them up before the snow and to start filling it over the winter so it'll be ready to go in the spring. Now, I'm not sure if I should order the dirt now or wait until spring. You know, will delivery even be possible in the spring the way things are going with the price of gas and everything? And now there's currently a fertilizer shortage, so try to pick some up now. I'm going to run over to Agway and see if they have any. I'm going to give you a future video on the fertilizer shortage. And I would advise getting your seeds now, as they too might be in short supply. Especially when people start noticing that they can't buy food and the stores are out of all the different foods that they might want, they might say, I better start growing some of my own food. And there go our seeds. The other thing I'm thinking I'm going to try to do is put some screening down on the ground and then maybe some cinder blocks or wood or something as a border around it. Then dump the dirt on it and see that if that's going to keep those voles or whatever's coming underground out and to stop them from eating my plants. So that's where I am now. Keep looking for future videos because I'll show you the final garden setup. Let me know what you're doing, and if you have any tips for us, please leave a comment and, of course, subscribe.